These are a series of videos explaining how to create a website. These videos were made while I was conducting workshops for the students of Satyanarayani Devi Shikshan Niketan, a rural school in Daryapur village near Rai Bareli in Uttar Pradesh, India. I'm sharing these videos on YouTube so that other students too may benefit from them. Let's start by understanding some fundamental attributes of communication. When it comes to communication, the first thing to understand is space or distance and time. Let's say you and your friend are standing close by and having a conversation. In this case, the distance between the person communicating and the person listening is almost zero. But if you are in Delhi and your friend is in Chennai, the distance is a few thousand kilometers. The first idea, space or distance, is understanding if the communication is between people nearby or far away. The second idea is time. Time means if something was said when time was equal to zero, then is the same information stored, preserved, and communicated in, say, time equals 1 year and, say, time equals 100 years. To understand the idea of space and time in communication, let's take the example of the pillars erected by Emperor Ashoka on which his edicts were written. When it comes to space or distance, this pillar is fixed in its location and it is not easy to physically move it around because it weighs a lot. So, when it comes to space or distance, people have to come to the pillar and the pillar cannot go across space. However, this pillar was around when time was equal to 1, around 250 BC, and it is still here at present when time equals around 2000 years. What we are saying here is that when it comes to Ashoka's pillar, the communication or edicts they contain can traverse across time, but not across space. Of course, today we can take a photo or a video of the pillar and send it across the globe, space. But physically, the pillar is fixed in terms of space, but it can traverse across time. Another aspect of communication is whether the communication is happening 1:1 or 1:many. When you are having a conversation with your friend, it is 1:1 communication. But when, say, the Prime Minister of India addresses the nation, it is 1:many communication. Another aspect of communication is accuracy versus efficiency. Communication is essentially dissemination of information, knowledge, ideas and thoughts across time and space, which means information needs to be disseminated, stored and preserved while maintaining its accuracy. Let's say there are 10 villages spread across a large forest. Each village is around a kilometer away from the other village. Village 1, then a kilometer away village 2, and so forth till village 10, which is 10 kilometers away from village 1. A message needs to be transmitted from village 1 to village 10. One of the first ways such long distance communication happened was in Africa by using drums. The message to be communicated was coded into different types of drum beats and was transmitted. To send a message from village 1 to village 10, village 1 would transmit to village 2, then on to village 3, and so on till the message reached village 10. In the game of Chinese whisper, also called telephone, a group of people sit together and one person whispers something to the person sitting next to him or her. The second person then whispers the same message to the next person and so on till the message reaches the last person in the group. If you have played this game, you know that usually the message gets totally distorted by the time the last person says it out loud. A famous example is the military message. Send reinforcements, we are going to advance. Which became, send 3 and 4 pence, we are going to a dance. With each hop, the chances of the message getting distorted increase. To maintain the accuracy of key piece of information that needs to be transmitted, you have to add some more information. In the case of the African drummers, let's say they had to convey the word sun, S-U-N, sun. To ensure that S-U-N, sun does not become S-O-N, sun, they would add more information to the message. For example, sun that shines in the sky. By adding more information to the key message, the drummers would ensure that even across hops from village 1 to village 10, the message remains clear and is not misinterpreted. S-U-N sun remains S-U-N sun and does not become S-O-N sun or something else. To the key message sun, by adding more information that shines bright in the sky, accuracy in communication is being ensured. However, this also makes communication inefficient. Inefficient in the sense that to transmit one word, sun, we are adding 5 more words that shines in the sky. Of course, We can add lesser number of words, but the point is we are adding something and hence making the communication inefficient. But we are fine with this trade-off because that is the price we are paying for maintaining accuracy. This process of adding more information to maintain accuracy of communication is called disambiguation. Ambiguous is that which can create confusion, and the process of disambiguation ensures that our message remains accurate even when it is transmitted across hops. In digital communication, bits of information are added to the beginning and end of the key message, and these extra bits are validated across hops to ensure that the message does not get distorted as it goes across the network from the source to the destination. Drums were among the first things used for long-distance communication, and many other mediums were also used, like fire to send smoke signals. This still happens in the Vatican. When the new pope has to be chosen, black smoke from the chimney means that a new pope has not been appointed yet, and white smoke means there is a new pope now. Flags were also used to communicate. Holding two flags, one in each hand, and changing the position was another way to send coded information. Ships still use flags to communicate with other ships. And you may have noticed, when an aircraft is pulling into its bay, the person on the ground communicates with the pilot with the help of flags. This is also an example of line of sight communication, where the person transmitting and the person receiving the communication have to remain in each other's sight. The last attribute of communication we will look at is lean forward and lean back forms of communication. Lean forward means a deeper engagement with the message or content of communication, and lean back implies a passive consumption of content. In school, when you are attending your classes, hopefully you are in a lean forward mode, engaging actively with what your teachers are saying. On the other hand, watching television is usually done in lean back mode. We become passive consumers of content while watching TV. In designing our website and all its contents, our objective will be to present information and content in such a way that our audience remains in a lean forward mode. That is, our audience is actively engaging with our content. In the next video, we will look at how medium of communication have evolved over time and discuss some of the major milestones in this story.